All right. Hello, everyone. Happy Easter. We're just going to wait and see, kind of wait just a minute as we do, just to let people hopefully join us that want to or that can. Hey, Kathy. Kathy's here. So we're just we're excited as a family to end our, I guess, end our Easter weekend with some praise and with worship. Doing it together with friends and with our family. Hey, Brooks, how's it going? And Rick. Brooks, he's not far away. I think he's down in Chattanooga, I think, or somewhere near there. So we're just going to give a little time here. We've had quite the day. We've been able to watch, between last night and today, I think we watched two or three or four different types of worship services, so it's awesome to be able to have so many options right now online. Hey, Carlos and Diana, they're here from Florida. Catherine from right next to me. Well, we'll see. I don't want to wait too long, but I know a lot of people, it's been a long day, so I have a feeling some people may already be crashing, but it's all good. So we just wanted to do some songs that were just kind of the Lord put on our hearts. Some are sort of Easter-ish, some maybe not so much, but they're just exalting Jesus in this place. I will say for people watching later, hey Donna, I think one of these next weeks, what we'll probably do is we need to awesome. Royce has crashed. All right. Sorry, Royce. Have a good rest. But one of these times, one of these days, I think we need to actually do a Facebook Live of our rehearsals and practices for this.
No.
Because, man, sometimes those are the real Owens family. You guys get a polished, nice view.
Like
yeah. Good. Hey, Bob. Bob, we're glad you're here. Hopefully Pam is or is nearby. So yeah, I think I saw Wendy on there maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I love seeing you, Donna. Yeah, Wendy's there. So and I don't know. I know our good friend Tim up in Pennsylvania had been throwing the lyrics up for everybody, which is kind of cool. He's probably had a pretty busy day too, so I don't know if he'll get to that. But if not, I'll just tell you what's coming, and we'll do this together. If not, just sing whatever comes to mind. That's okay. So man, it's just good to have you guys here, and we'll watch as people are coming in. We'll try to catch you. And once again, hey Bart, if you guys have prayers or scripture or things that just come to mind as we're doing this, feel free to join in. Happy Resurrection Day to you as well. All right, so we're going to just start off. We're going to kind of jump right at it. We're just going to do, we raised a hallelujah, you did this a few weeks ago. And it's just a good, it's a good declaration song, I think, as we start, as we just acknowledge what Jesus has done. So we'll get right out of here. So join in. We'll try to watch everybody. Yep. All right. One, two, three, four. In the presence of my enemies, and I raise a hallelujah louder. raise a hallelujah in the midst of everything that's going on, God. And I know there's just so much, even just in the midst of our families and our issues that we struggle with, God, you are still King. You are still good. We are still hidden in you, Lord. So we thank you for being the God who is all in all. And you are so worthy, God, in this time we recognize it, but it's always. We know you are worthy. You came into this earth, you lived and you died and you rose again for our salvation. And you sent your Spirit to be with us so that we can join together with brothers and sisters in this bond and worship together.
Jesus, you will reign forevermore.
So we're going to sing, we're going to do a newer version kind of Because He Lives. It's called Because He Lives, or Amen is another version by Matt Maher, if you want to pull it up for those who may not know it. And then we're actually going to head into the traditional, the old school Gaither, Because He Lives after that. So here we go. Lord, we just want to affirm that tonight, that life, no matter what it, how it comes, no matter what happens, it's worth living because of you, not because of any other thing. So I think now we'll just take just a couple seconds or a couple minutes maybe, and we can, you can do it out loud if you're alone or with family, or you can do it by yourself. Just maybe tell God the things that he is greater than. Like, God, you are greater than even my family, my home, my job, my health. You are greater than that. Knowing you is greater than those things. Having you, being in you, being in Christ is greater than any of the things we could ever have on this earth. But because of that, God, because we are in you, it makes this, the life on this earth, worth living. We look forward to the life to come, God, but we also take joy in the life we have here because you are worthy and you have made it worth it all. So, Lord, we just speak those things out to you now, the things that you are greater than, and just affirm that you are worth it all. Tim, welcome, brother. I enjoyed it this morning. We were watching some of HBIC's broadcast, and Tim's kids hijacked his phone and were commenting in, and that was kind of fun to watch, Tim. They had a lot of power there when they could type and say hi to everybody. That was cool. So we're going to sing a newer song. It's called I Will Boast in Christ. There's a hymn that's buried within it that I think you'll recognize. And we'll be right back. Song, one of the lyrics on there, I think it says, all my failures could not erase. So love will never lose its power, all my failures could not erase. And in just a dumb, small way, I was referencing this earlier, well, maybe it's not so small, but when we were, I said we should, for those who were on early, I said maybe we should actually in a few weeks do just Facebook Live, just our practice, where everyone's kind of grumpy a little bit, and I get kind of, I get a little bit of a control freak sometimes, maybe, I guess. But it was a bit of a failure, and among many. But I think when we come to times, especially like Easter, but all the time, we can actually go, you know what, I'm not going to let that influence the way I see Jesus or the way I think he sees me, because I am in Christ, and I'm always perfect in Christ. I am always righteous no matter what. And the Father sees me as righteous no matter what. In my best times, when I'm worshiping and everybody's worshiping together with me, when I'm leading it, or when I'm being a bit of a jerk. Yeah, I'm going to put my thing on pretty quick. But those are still times where we're in Christ. And when we're in Christ, we are perfect. And we are righteous and we are good and we are holy because of him, not because of us. And so, man, if that doesn't make us sing these songs over and all.
So grateful.
Yeah, what can wash away my sin? Jesus did it. He does it every day. He did it once and for all, Hebrews says. On the cross, he made us righteous. And then thankfully, he sent his Spirit who is continuing to make us more like him. Some of us have more farther to go than others, but we are thankful for that. So Jesus, I thank you for your righteousness, God. What it cost you, God, it cost you your Son, and Jesus, it cost you your life. It cost you separation from your Father. You came down from heaven to live with us, to be a sacrifice that we could not pay. Thank you for that, and it makes all this life, it makes it worthwhile, and it makes us want to sing, want to praise, want to pray, want to talk to you, want to be with you.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
as soon as I see you, Kim, I wonder where she's watching from. You're at the hospital or maybe you're home. Welcome. I'm glad you're here. All right, I want to share something else real quick. I know I just talked there for a minute, but there was something. I'll play for just a minute, hitting on this. So there was a text, a passage that was really on my heart today, and I wanted to share it, and then it brought up a song that we're going to try here. And it's from Luke. If I can find it. Here we go. I'm sorry, it's from John. Take that back. But it's actually early, way, way back before what we're celebrating on Easter weekend, but early on and what really probably started the whole ball rolling to end up in the crucifixion. Jesus got up and said something which blew people's minds. It was at the last feast. It was at the last day of the greatest feast that the Jews celebrated. And he said this. He said, Jesus stood up and cried out. So he cried out to everyone. He said, "If anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water." And now this he said about the Spirit, whom those who believed in him were to receive, which we're actually going to be celebrating in a few weeks with Pentecost. Because of what he did, he could then, and then he died, he was raised, he went back to his Father, he sent his Spirit, and out of us is flowing rivers of living water. And what my prayer for tonight was, as we were doing this, because you've probably been through lots of church services today. Hey, Ted, how's it going? Hey, Farrah. And you've had chances to watch sermons and worship together. But if anything, tonight, what was the picture that I got in my head was there's rivers of living water that are flowing up in us because of Christ's Spirit, because of what he's done. And that's flowing out. It's flowing into every home that watches this. People watch it later on. And I'm just praying that the Spirit is flowing into you. It is flowing into your home. It is flowing into your area where you live, into your state, whatever it is, your city. And it's welling up in you too for those of us who are believers. And so that was a promise from Jesus. He said, those who are thirsty will find rivers of living water in him. And so tonight, that's just kind of my prayer, that this fount of river of life and blessing would be flowing to you guys tonight. Particularly at this time where I've been watching I go back and watch our other videos in the last 4 weeks, and we kind of look a little worse from where each week as I've watched it. We were pretty fresh 4 weeks ago, and I think everybody's just weighing on us. But we have rivers of living water that Jesus has given us, which is better than anything else we can need or want. And so we're going to do a song, you know well, an old hymn with a little tag on it that's a little different, but it's "Come Thou Fount of the Blessings of Jesus." And so we're going to sing this together. Sorry. I don't know that one. We'll do it in the same key, hopefully. All right. I'm gonna keep going. I don't remember playing it. Here we go. Let's do that again. Hey, Candace. Yeah. There, because Wendy said she lived for those types of moments. Thank you, Wendy, for living for our moments of messing up. And also, Chuck, our dog, started to drink Kate's water, or Catherine's water, right in the middle of that. That was pretty funny.
I have some. See that part.
Yeah, we didn't. You guys couldn't see that one, but hey, Danny.
Hey.
And Laura. What? Somebody say something we need to read?
No.
Oh yeah, we had a. Okay, so. Real quick, we'll take a break. Danny's back.
I can just come over.
God, that's fun. So, here's Sam. Oh, yeah, you want to come around here? Sam is here. He was playing the drums. You could probably hear him. Everyone wonders what happened to him. Sorry, I'm not going to hurt you.
I don't want to die.
He's not dying to be on the camera, so it's not like we're just sticking him in the corner. Although, with a drum, we do have to kind of put him in the corner. But, oh, that's fun. Candace Winger, just remembered. Yeah, the California Friends.
That's right.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to do, we had a request for this one. Maddie requested
what?
It.
No.
We're going to do a few more songs here. Yeah.
Very, yeah.
Again, if you guys have any, Sybil says hi.
Hi, Sybil.
If there's anything on anybody's heart here, we just, anytime.
I'm just grateful. I can't type it in the chat box. I'm just grateful for Jesus. I know that's like all day the theme of Easter, but I'm just so grateful for Easter. And I don't know if anybody else's heart is like mine, but that's where I'm sitting all day long. So just to share that.
Yep. And I got to say too, and not to put out plugs for anything, but we've just had a great, I've loved watching everybody else's families, like what everybody's doing and different things that they're, kind of how they're getting through it, but this last couple weeks for sure has just been really cool. We love this. We love doing this with you guys. We've been watching. There's a few what's the name of it? I'm blanking. Sight and Sound Theater up in Pennsylvania where we used to live. They put out for free on TBN a Jesus musical that they've done that we'd seen while we were up there, which is awesome. It's only today's the last day, so tonight go check it out on TBN.com. Awesome.
So good.
Hey Marjorie, good to see you. So we did that. Also, we've been watching The Chosen online or on YouTube, which is unbelievable. So that's been awesome. Tim said, did you do What a Beautiful Name? No. I didn't have that on the list, I didn't think, but maybe I did. Oh, I don't think we're doing that one. No, I don't know what happened. But sorry, Tim. I don't know. We did that. And then last night we watched our Two Rivers church service, and then today we watched Elevation. I mean, there's just so many amazing things going on that we can be part of, which is so cool. At a time where we have to all slow down, and then to have all this stuff that's just at our fingertips, ready to worship and ready to be together with the family of God is so cool. Ooh, you sure you didn't drink? You just drank some Chuck water there. Anyway, guys, I'm done talking. I'm sorry. But it just feels like we're all kind of hanging out together here. So, yeah, they like us. Oh, Tim was making a suggestion, huh? Maybe next week. We don't always move well on the fly doing things, but we will do that one. I love that song.
Next week.
5 business days.
Yeah, 3 to 5 business days. Yeah, if you order a song, it takes, yeah, it takes
a little bit.
3 to 5 business days. I love that. But we are going to do a song with Beautiful in it, so. Yeah. All right. Love having you guys here. Jesus, I thank you again. I thank you for Easter. We are so thankful. And I also thank you. I just love interacting with our friends. And God, we're so wealthy in friends to have fellow believers and family and friends who come alongside us and who support and encourage us and who worship together with us. God, it feels like a little tiny bit of heaven, and we're longing for that. But while we're here, we get to do this, and that is so cool. So Jesus, I pray right now that specifically, I just pray that each person who's taken the time to join in and watch us, hey Steve, Jesus, that you would just bless them tonight for taking this time out, God. They could be doing other things, they could be doing whatever, but they're taking time to worship you, and that's just a good thing. And so I pray that you would bless them for this. And God, even now, if you're just, that your spirit would be speaking to them, speaking words of comfort, words of hope. Lord, specifically, if there's something in their mind right now, I know often something jumps right to the front of their mind that they've been praying for, God, I pray that you would give them a word for that time, for this season, that you would just speak to them in this place while we're worshiping together, while we're joining together. Just speak words to them that they need to hear, God. Confirm it in their spirit that you are with them, you're watching over them. But there is hope. There's a future. You've given us hope and a future, like it says in Jeremiah. Stephanie. So guys, man, thanks for joining us. Before we close, we just want to do one more song. It's kind of a, for me, it's like kind of this classic, newer, not that new, but newer, older song, Easter song that we love to do, and we're going to do it together. It's Happy Day, just as a celebration. We want to send this weekend off, this day off, as a celebration into this next year. And also, like I said before, in some ways, in Christian tradition, hey, Stephen, we are moving into the next few weeks into Pentecost, and that's another huge celebration as well. We look forward to just celebrating that the Holy Spirit has been poured out. These rivers of living water are poured out over us as His people. And so it's just good to do that. Kind of unrelated, but as I was doing that, you know how your mind goes multiple different ways. Earlier I just mentioned some stuff we've been doing. If you're looking for things over the next couple weeks, as things maybe get more downtime, we also, and I don't know why it came to mind, but just things that we've been doing that have been blessing us in this time. There's a guy, a musician, his name is Andrew Peterson, but he's also an author, and a few years ago he wrote about 10 or 15 years ago, he wrote a series of books called The Wingfeather Saga, which if you have kids or grandkids, awesome books for
they're
them.
Fantastic.
It's they're just fantastic. A series of four, but he has been reading them, and it's just so much fun. He does all the voices, and he's been reading them out loud on his Facebook channel. So Andrew Peterson or The Rabbit Room on Facebook, you can find him there. He's been reading through, he read through book one. Tomorrow night he's going to start book two. I think they're still on there, but you can also pick up the books. They just got re-released. So just huge, love that, a blessing for us. Also, you know, there's a lot of our friends. I know, I don't think she's watching tonight, but Angela Pinkston, they're doing music, playing keyboard, you know, just there's a lot of stuff. You just look around, man, you can find just stuff to bless you right now during this time, stuff to lift us up. We need to keep, I think, if I could, and I have struggled with it too, but just stopping the news, stopping the stuff that's going to make us scared and worried and just turn our eyes on us and just turn our eyes on Jesus. So if that's worship like this, if it's prayer, if it's calling, call one another, get on Zoom, get on FaceTime, whatever it is, just connect with other believers, encourage other believers. Yes, thank you, Stephanie. You're right. Writing, so remember, yes, the Wingfeather, might be one word, but Wingfeather Saga, that is Andrew Peterson, and all of his stuff. And actually today he just put out, he has a series called the Resurrection Letters. This is actually music that he's done where it's all taking kind of the life, the Easter story, and does songs. And he did some of that live, or he put it out live today. I think they recorded it this last week
That's
or
really
two.
Good.
But it was awesome. I mean, he's just awesome. His lyrics are incredible. So check that out too if you can. I think that's on his Andrew Peterson's page too. Good guy. So, and he's nearby us. I think he's in Nashville. Everyone is in Nashville. So anyway, we're going to close, guys. Thanks for coming. Stop talking here.
All that to say,
we're happy day, man. We're just excited to celebrate this day, and we're going to send it off this way. Hopefully, we'll see how it goes. But my kids love this song. But it's a good one. So, guys, thanks so much for joining us. And if you need, you might even need to stand up on this one. I don't know, but all right. I gotta get the right rhythm. One, two, three, four. We'll be right back. does not change the day. Yeah, that's right. So you haven't really been a parent, I gotta say this, until you have one kid on one side who's saying, "Dad, you're speeding up," which I was, I think, and the other looking at me because I forgot the words. It's just awesome. Sorry. But I agree with Wendy. That is the best news ever, no matter how we play it. Matter of fact, we often go back and listen just to see if the Holy Spirit fixed stuff, because a lot of times He makes it better than we deserve.
Yeah.
But it is just an awesome, it's an awesome privilege to worship together with you guys. Kathy, we thank you for being here. Candace, it was so great to see you. And I'm sorry, I can't remember everybody. Hey, Steve. Justin and Carly, you guys made it awesome. I saw Miriam earlier from Canada. Thank you for being here. Happy Easter, everybody. He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
He is risen indeed. Have a blessed week. I pray that the rivers of living water just flow through to you and to all those around you this next week. We love you guys. Bye bye. Sam, say bye.
Oh, Becca.
Becca's here. Hey, Becca. Sorry. Bye.
Becca.
Bye. We love you guys.